The world is ending, though few believe it. The Chaos Gods, the Dark Brothers, tire of their great game. Now, they seek to sweep the board clean with fire and blood. For centuries, the Empire has held firm against its enemies. Mankind has encountered no foe that steel could not tame, or whom walls could not hold. At least, that is what they taught. No one spoke of the ancient enemy now rising from beneath, and no one will be left to tell the tale. Unless you can stem the Vermintide.
A trap!
Look out!
Hey guys, and welcome to Warhammer Vermintide. So, this is a game very much like Left 4 Dead. So, you pretty much complete objectives. You fight through areas to complete objectives. Not much else really to say about that. That's just your main goal. You'll have various objectives, but your end objective is always just kind of to get to the way game and escape. So, just want to do a quick explanation here. Don't want it to be too long because I know you guys want to get into the action. So, housekeeping. We're going to be doing a co-op let's play here. It'll be with myself and Radian. The reason we're just doing two people is the difficulty in finding good let's players to play with, and B, scheduling issues. So, I'd love to do with more than one person, but it's often not practical in the real world because you can't play with the same people over and over again consistently to record. Secondly, I'm going to try to record good episodes, and by good I mean episodes where we are successful, where I show off all the locations of the tomes and grimoires. We'll get into what those do, but pretty much right now they're just hidden items. And then lastly, just a little explanation on how that's going to work. So we're going to record probably several playthroughs at once, but the one that's successful is the one you will see, and the rest I think I'll release as like a blooper reel or like unsuccessful in a bonus episodes. So if you're only interested in seeing the successfuls, the bonus episodes might not be as interesting, and they're going to be the same mission we already played. And lastly, I just want to do a very quick explanation of weapon news and some other things. So, the characters very, very quickly. Witch Hunter? I always want to call him the Witch Doctor. So, Witch Doctor is generally fast attack, low damage, average amount of targets, with a focus on headshots. So, headshots, which we see on most of the Templar's weapons. I guess just the Rapier, but Rapier's kind of the recommended weapon for him. As well as the Dwarf Crossbow. So, what headshots do is you hit the head, you do a lot of bonus damage. However, here, you can attack quickly, so if you get headshots, you can kill a lot of rats really quickly if you're accurate. Because it's low damage, fast attack, but bonus for headshots. The Dwarf Crossbow is fast attack, slow attack, high damage. So you get a huge bonus for headshots. So that means specials you can kill very efficiently. So that's kind of the focus there. Secondly, there's also characters like the Dwarf The dwarf is generally high damage, but you also get armor penetration. So certain enemies use armor, so you want attacks that penetrate armor. You don't always need it on both. However, if you look, the charge attack for the dwarf isn't that much better, but it has a lot of knockback and more targets. So, for the dwarf, if you look at like this hammer, or the hammer and shield, does even less damage, has more targets and knockback. But again, you have to use that charge attack to penetrate, which is pretty low damage. So, by sticking with the axe and shield, we get that penetrate attack on every attack, and we can attack quite quickly. And we don't have to use a slow shield charge attack. So, and the thing is, if you combo them, they're actually not that much slower, but often you're going to attack twice, kill an enemy, attack again, or you might want to attack and block, where if you have to charge and then block, you leave yourself open for a lot more time. And since there's no one here, there's not really anybody to compare to. And again, like I said, we're going to do this quickly, so the ranger, like this is the ranger, way watcher, yeah, they call it dwarf ranger, but I ask this character more like ranger because they have a bow. So anyway, so the bow deals lots of damage slowly, so it's kind of the opposite of the crossbow. Lots of little damage attacks, really good for if you can headshot rats, you can kill 5 rats really quickly. So kind of a crowd control, same with the swords, low damage but and no targets, but good crowd control. See here, you can hit several enemies, decapitate one, you're only capturing one at once, but much faster attack speed. Lastly, the wizard is that a wizard deals different fire attacks. It's better if you see them, but different attacks do have armor penetration. I guess all the first attacks do, so. And then the soldier is just the soldier. He's kind of like the dwarf, but generally, I haven't seen people as impressed with him as a dwarf, so. Guess because of his weapons are different. But anyway, guys, like I said, didn't want to burden you with too much information right off the bat, so we will get into the gameplay. Okay, guys, we're now in the matching screen. This is Radian. The elf. That's him. So anyway, we're going to get ready and find some randoms.
My recording frame rate is terrible. Let's fix that.
Are you recording at, like, 1080 or something?
Yeah. Well, I got a new hard drive. Well, I got 2 hard drives and rated them together, so they're like substantial compared to what I was using.
Oh, okay.
And I also bought a second 970, so like I can support the frame rate, no problem, but the hard drives just were not doing it. I found out that this game is actually super intensive on my CPU.
Yep, it would be.
But I feel like it should be more on my GPU.
Well, but I guess that makes sense. Yeah, I know you're right. I was thinking GPU instead of CPU.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's hardly touching my GPU at all. I'm sitting at, like, 50% on each of them. Maybe less.
Because, yeah, there shouldn't be that much CPU. Oh.
Exactly. Bloody catastrophe. Our alarm is the great big hall in Magnus Tower, and you must go there and let the world know we're under attack.
Check on the nearby guardhouse on your way, and with any luck, they can assist you. Okay, so anyway, guys, our goal here is to blow a big horn and alert everybody to the presence of the Skaven. It is Ubersreik 2523 IC. How is that what you say at Radian?
I'd say so.
Something like that.
But we're also going to try and make it as difficult as possible for ourselves. We'll get all 3 tomes and both, what are they called, crucibles?
Grimoires.
Grimoires, that's what it is. I knew it was a word like that.
Exactly. So, and we'll try to move a little bit quickly, just so we don't get slayed by being a little bit too slow. It can be good. It can be good to look around and find stuff. Oh, go ahead.
We know that those always spawn. We decided to open the game up to 2 random people just because the bots, as you saw in
the bonus content, which you'll see.
Yeah.
If you watch the bonus content.
It's my first episode, but it was basically the introduction where we just got wrecked, because it was basically us two plus two bots, and that was awesome.
Yeah. No bombs.
It wasn't a good time. No bombs? Are they healing?
Just potions.
There's medical supplies down here.
Oh, there is? Nice.
And healing draft. I'm actually going to pronounce it correctly and call it a draft now. Instead of a drought.
I thought it was a drought.
Well, I mean...
Or drought. So drought's what I say.
Drought is probably right. I was calling it drought, like we weren't getting any rain.
Oh, okay. I think they're healing draughts.
That's probably right, but I mean, when you get, like, beer on tap, it's called being on draft, but it's spelled like that, right?
No, draft is spelled D-R-A-F-T. That's draft beer.
I guess, but...
At least where I live.
Say draft. I guess some people don't differentiate between a draw and a draft.
Possibly.
I always say what's on tap, so...
Yep.
That's an entirely...
So guys, we have, as I was talking about, the charge attack, which does a knockback, and then just the chopping attack, which does kind of more... a similar amount of damage, but does not knock back, so...
I don't do hardly any armor piercing, so it'll be good for me to take out the little ones, since you're the dwarf with the badass crossbow, and I got her.
Can you... Okay, you got her?
I got her.
I'll come up with you guys so I don't get cornered. What was it, a packmaster?
Yeah. I started calling them hook rats. But yes, it was a packmaster.
Yeah. Okay. Do you need more ammo?
So I'm going to leave the big bad enemies to you, and I'll just kind of...
I 100% agree.
The ammo here if you need it.
I haven't even used one shot yet.
I think I've used one. Let's see what I can pick off.
Yeah, you should try to pick off... You should pick off enemies whenever we can. She got,
yeah, we did kind of start to develop a strategy last time. He actually still have that tome? Yes.
Yes, we have tome one.
Yeah, but he put it down for a second too.
He picked up the tome, then he used his healing item, or dropped it, picked up his healing item, and picked it back up.
Gotcha.
So, there's speed over there if you need it.
I just realized I wasn't recording, but we didn't miss much. I had an issue with frame rate at the beginning, but it's not going to matter. We're you know, at the very beginning, and if you really want to see the ultra beginning for this mission, just go check out my first episode.
So.
Playlist in the usual spot.
And guys, I will link to Raiden's channel in the description if you're interested in seeing his content. However, it's likely going to be very similar to what you're going to see on my channel. So carefully, yep, there's a goblin deer there. I tried to get him, but he kind of... He's hopping around.
The main difference is that you'll see it from the elf's point of view.
There we go. Got him.
Alright, so the first Grimoire is over here, right? Oh, Sacrat!
Okay.
Try and get ahead of him!
If you can, like, yeah, if you can just stun lock him. Also, there's a goblin deer, like, behind you.
Yeah. Oh. Sacrat's down.
Goblin deer's down.
What do we got here? Ogre!
Oh, where? Oh, right in front of me. Throwing the bomb in.
I don't have a bomb.
Throwing the second bomb.
I'll worry about these little guys.
Okay. Dodge.
Commander over here too.
That's kind of bad.
We got some healing draughts here too, so...
Yeah, luckily we got that pack rat, so there's lots of healing.
Oh god. Okay, thank you.
What happened? Something
steam
happened?
Overlay. I hit shift and steam overlay popped up. Okay, that was actually not bad.
Nope, now there's a... I think this is an ambush. Because at least I didn't hear... Did you hear the horn?
I think I did.
Oh, okay.
I heard a roar, at least.
I looked at... Well, that would have been the ogre. So, I looked it up. I did some research. There's three types of events that you usually hear, other than, like, the specials. There's a big horn, which is always the... How to say? It's always just the ambushes.
Right.
And... Or, sorry, that is... The horn is that's like a horde. Then you have ambushes, which are smaller mounts, but you're not warned.
Okay.
So the first Grimoire guide is right in here. And then you might not see this, but it's right in here. So.
All right, you got the first one.
Got the first one.
All right. No speed or strength potions for you.
So, nope. Which kind of sucks, but I don't want to let one of these randoms drop our Grimoire. So, the second tome is in here. Do recommend be careful, because specials can corner you in here. Especially if there's a horde or something, it can be a really bad place to get cornered.
Let's see, Bright Witch already has a tome, I'll get the second one.
No. So. You got the second one?
Yep.
Perfect, I'll grab third.
That's two tomes. Got a runner.
Got it off, yeah.
Not dead? Yeah.
Good, I got two axe shots into it, so I was hoping we'd get it.
You can actually stunlock them into a corner. There's another one here, I hear it.
Yeah, it's on the roof. Oh no, that's something else. But yes, I hear it as well. I'll hold out my crossbow just in case. Oh good, we got a loot die.
Nice, that's two loot dies actually.
Oh, he only dropped one? The pack rat? The sack rat?
Sack rat dropped one, and that was the second one.
Okay, I saw it drop two earlier, but...
Oh, did it? Then maybe we're at three.
Well, I'm not sure. I'd have to check the chat log.
That's fine.
No, it looks like it only dropped one.
Beep, 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 beep. Alright.
Okay, so you can run the barrels?
I got the first one.
Okay.
It's actually better to toss them, but since I have a speed potion, I'll do the first one.
Sure. It's gonna quickly... Just gonna quickly get the full health just in case I need it here.
Yep, that's fine.
The other thing I just did, you guys, you saw it, is you can, if you have the shield, I'm not sure about the other blocks.
Oh, crap.
You can actually do a block attack. You need help?
No, they hit the barrel.
Like the enemies did?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So it started to spark a little bit.
Just gonna quickly check this room while we have a second. There's medical supplies in here.
Okay. We're gonna get the last barrel in a second here.
How do I throw it? I just click?
Yeah, click will throw. Oh, gunner.
Got him.
Nice, I got the barrel.
Roger.
Woo.
This guy, he's fighting a gunner runner, he's ballsy.
You can solo them as long as you sidestep the first attack.
Oh, okay. So
I want to. Yeah, coming out of the source.
Go grab that medical and heal yourself. Oh well, Zalian actually needs healing. I'm gonna heal him and grab that medical supplies. I don't know where he is though.
That's probably good. Oh, well, there's a bunch of healing supplies right through the store.
Yeah, that too.
It doesn't look like there's a patrol here.
Perfect. So guys, the third, this third tome isn't for a bit, so you don't have to worry about these areas too much for looking for tomes and grimoires. And then the last grimoire is kind of... It's about probably about three quarters through. Oh, Gatling rat, careful. Oh, I missed him, I think. But looks like our good Bright Witch friend got him, which is always nice.
I'm going to take out some of these little ones for you guys.
Sounds good. I shouldn't actually be fighting them in melee. Should be letting you range guys deal with them.
What's happening back there?
I think she got knocked down by something.
Good, bomb.
Does she still have her tome? Okay. You have to watch these people because sometimes they'll drop tomes like idiots for some reason.
That's what I said one time when he discarded the tome. I was like, that's not good.
Yeah. Oh, good job.
Nice shot.
Yeah, I had him in my crosshairs and I just saw him drop, so that's always good. So yeah, we're actually doing pretty good with these randoms.
I mean, so it's level 18 and level 6. They've played through a bit.
That's true.
They're not brand new.
Yeah, that's a good point.
And this really is, like, the longest mission in the game as far as I'm aware.
So, make sure you try the... I'll show you that second grimoire, but make sure you try to grab it so... One of them don't get it and lose it on us.
I know where it is, I just don't know how to open the wall.
Yeah. It's pretty easy, so. I don't feel good.
I wonder if they know how to get to this tome up here.
I do,
but I don't know if they do.
But, like, we can drop it. Like, we can drop it, and then they can pick up the one we drop.
Assuming we can find something.
But, as you know... Oh.
Ah, perfect. There we go. I'll leave that there. Make sure somebody grabs that.
I'm highlighting it for him. You got it. You're good.
Alright.
So, I'll be the healer then. Keeping up. Oh, where's she actually?
Oh.
God damn it. I was gonna go heal her.
Good.
Why can't I? Good. Why can't I heal her? Oh, cause I have my Grimoire. That's why. Where'd she go?
I guess, alright. Let's do the jump.
There you go.
Here's the third tome.
Yep. So you...
jumped a little early.
Actually, maybe I'll grab your potion from you as well.
I know you can make this jump. I've done it.
I made it first time last time. If you hug the wall, it's easier.
There we go.
Like, double hug the wall.
There we go. Got it. I'm going to take this draft.
No, give it to me, please. Oh, shit.
Oh,
that's why I came.
I didn't even notice. Oh, is that what that was?
I'm as a half health, yeah. There'll be more stuff, but I did say, like, leave it for me, but it's fine.
I didn't understand.
Oh, perfect. There's medical supplies.
There you go.
I'll just grab them.
Take that.
Or did she?
No, they're up here still.
So what you do is you hit this candle till they're out right here, which I already hit.
Yes.
And then you can go right here and grab it. I think she already grabbed it though, so we're good.
Okay. Interesting. Perfect. No, that's how you do it. And you got that.
I got the draw up there, yep.
Interesting. So that's how you do it. Okay.
That is how you do it.
Look at you doing your research.
Yeah, compared to you who had no clue how to get it, so.
I like to figure it out.
Okay, well, I like to.
Painfully.
I just like to know.
I like the journey.
Bombs. I'll chill here. You just take them out.
Yep. And they're coming through the...
Yep.
You might want to...
I'll chill here and hold them at this bridge point.
Alright, we should be good on this side. Oh no, there's more. Wow. Look at you holding that line.
Best I can.
Oh, I got hooked. Thank you.
Okay. Well, the dwarf is the best character for holding the line because you can use the shield block.
Right.
And it hits exactly the number of guys that tend to be on that corner.
God, this is so much easier with two randoms.
Yeah, exactly. We're only doing normal is the thing, too. So...
Oh, I mean...
We can always try the difficulties later on, but...
Let's unlock all of the difficulties.
That's what I was going to say, do them all first.
Yeah.
So that's, we've all three keys and all four group, and the two Grimoires. So if we make it, we're going to get some pretty good loots.
I hope. Gas rat.
Oh shit!
Uh-oh.
God damn, I'm dead.
Uh-oh.
I'm dead.
I can't get back. Yeah, no, you're dead. What'd you have? Do you have anything? You have a Grimoire.
Yeah. I have a Grimoire, yeah.
Yeah, I can't help you.
No, this is my bad.
Oh, I got somebody else!
Oh, shit, he can help me now! Ah, well, can he grab? No, he can't grab it. Because I had a Grimoire. So close.
What? Well, we still have all three tomes. And one Grimoire.
That's rough. But anyway, guys,
I can't imagine that worked.
Well, because he got pulled over the edge.
Yeah, I know, but that was... Did he do that on purpose?
No, he didn't. Well, I don't think he did it on purpose. But...
So you should be coming back alive in a second.
Yep. You have to come rescue me, though. It'll have to go up the thing first. I'm going to spawn up there. For sure. So anyway, guys,
oh,
when you do die...
There you are.
you spawn somewhere else on the map to be rescued. So.
So did you just die like super quick because the health reduction?
Yes, exactly.
Oh, commanders.
Plus you guys can get to me. But yes, right, but, that's, I mean, the, that's the main reason. That's the main reason, yes. But like, the reason I took so much damage is he put me up on his pole so quickly, because you guys couldn't get to me. If you chase the pole rat, he doesn't put you up on his pole.
Right.
But once he puts you up on the pole, you lose health extremely quickly.
That's
like,
annoying.
Like, even at full health, you'll die in a couple seconds.
Really? That
close? Or like, even without the Grimoire meant. Yeah, it's, you drain super quick once you're up on the pole.
Man, you're way the hell up here.
Don't go too quickly. Don't get yourself cornered. Oh, you're good.
You?
There's not too many. There's only two guys. I'm just wondering, I'm just saying in case you got hit by a gutter runner, we don't want like two people down. Because then you'd be pinned and you wouldn't be able to.
There you go.
So now I know, well, you learn something every day.
Oh.
I was gonna shoot him, but then he ran away.
Oh man, that sucks.
Well, it happens. The thing is, it doesn't affect. Well, it will affect one of our dice, because one of them would be a guaranteed dice.
Right. Another gunner?
Looks to be.
Alright, well, I see the gas rat. I don't think I can hit him from here, though. Oh, he's going up the stairs. Come on, buddy.
Got him?
Yep. Alright, I think we have everything. I got my tome.
I guess I'll heal myself.
We have all three tomes.
That's the gas rat. Okay. Okay.
Pull the lever, Kronk.
Sound the horn.
I got it.
So yeah, like I just typed in chat, the best place to hold is on the stairs. Because rats can only attack you from two directions rather than four.
Well, they can come over the wall.
Oh yeah, but that's still, they're only ever going to be in front of it or behind you. Because you're if you hug the wall. And if you watch as they climb, I can just kind of chop their heads off. So.
Okay.
So I'm assuming you're gonna hold my back and I'll hold my front.
Yeah, we'll be good.
Roger.
Nothing's spawning over here. You have literally all of them.
Okay. Like I said, just keep an eye. Cause like I read on the wiki, it's better than two people being covering one direction than four people being covered one direction and you get flanked. Cause you only need one or two people covering a direction anyway.
I agree. I definitely think this is the way to do it.
Yeah. Let me know if you see any specials as well.
I will. You should also be able to hear it, I think, but.
Yeah. The only thing when I died is I lost half my ammo.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Much?
Yep. I when you saved me, I had exactly half ammo. And I'm sure I didn't die with that much.
Oh, coming in.
Coming in. Oh, I'll cover the other way then.
Alright. Just a pile of bodies, I love it.
Yeah. You guys good that direction?
Yep, we're good.
Our direction's good as well.
They're swarming. Stand clear. Oh, gas, but way the hell up there.
Chaos. Yeah, that's the thing, is it's cloudy now, it's hard to see them.
There we go.
Commanders? No.
I nailed the timer on that strength potion.
Oh, shoot. You guys are getting kind of surrounded.
Nah, we're good. Gunner runner somewhere.
Yeah.
Oh, Pac-Man. Hook rat. Hook rat.
Got him.
Maybe. Gunner runner. Dodged. Oh, he got me anyway.
I got him with the crossbow, so...
That was the world's quickest turnaround there, gutter runner. I dodged him, and then he was like, nah, never mind.
Well, like, he should be low health, because I hit him with the crossbow.
I mean, I sidestepped him. He bounced off the wall and then got me. I guess he technically wasn't never hit
Oh,
the
there's
ground.
One behind you. Got it.
Okay. Yeah, oh.
God. Oh, I see him. I got one hit into him.
That should be just about
no,
it.
No, there's still...
Here it comes.
There's still the gutter runner.
Let's go.
Okay. Pull it.
Yep. One of your allies is injured. You mean all of them?
Five tomes that he still got is in the orange.
Game telling me.
Considering we would have had 33% less health, we might not have made it with all three Grimoires.
No, probably not. But then we also could have picked each other off.
Yeah, that's true.
Not saying it would have been a guarantee, but. Yeah, here, Assassin Rat.
Got one right at the last second. Picked them off. It's just like, just as the door was closing.
Alright.
So guys, you get XP based on how many people survive, the difficulty, and the number of tomes you collect. So if you see here, we have... Okay, well I got a recurve crossbow from being a level. So if you level, you get bonus items. Oh, I didn't quite get to explain it in time, but... Pretty much we got XP based on the things plus bonus dice. So, it shows here, if you... The normal dice from top to bottom... That is just the normal dice you get. You get seven of them, and they're replaced as you go through. So they have, as you see, a 2 in 6 chance of getting. So every time you roll, you get a 2 in 6 result. The second one is tome dice. Or sorry, those are the loot dice we get from the gas rat. And then the last one, or the third, is the tome dice. So you have 33%, 50%, 60%, and 100% on Grimoires. So I actually rolled, if you go back, I rolled all my dice but one successfully. So I got the second best item that was there. So.
You had a much better roll than I did.
What did you get?
I got a green.
Oh, I rolled.
Like I got four.
I rolled all my dice but one. So yeah,
pretty good.
Grimoire give you 100% roll. And then tomes are, 4 out of 6, 2 out of 3, 66%. Didn't look at any of my stats, but busy talking about the loot rolls. Loot rolls are an important system, which I think make this game very, very interesting. So if you guys are wondering what different difficulties do, different difficulties affect what rares you get on the roll. So if you're playing on hard, there'll be more rare cards. You still will have a... possibly have a white on the bottom, but you might have a green at the bottom, so you're guaranteed a green. On Nightmare, you're guaranteed a green or a blue, actually. So this is the
really?
Fusion system. You can fuse 5 items together to get a new one. You cannot fuse the items that you get generally. So, I do not want to fuse. We can upgrade. And I don't know if I have enough. Oh, I do have enough acid to upgrade this. So, when hitting any, there's a 5 to 12% chance to recover health. So we may as well upgrade that, because this is definitely a weapon I want to use. And then you can salvage weapons. So you generally don't want to salvage lower level weapons unless you want that type of thing. See, I need more common and rares, so I'm going to save my stuff for common and rare in the same line. So I now have the revolver, which you cannot... zoom in, but you can see how it works. So, oh no, this is actually the shotgun, it looks like. I thought this was the revolver, but...
Which one are you using? The,
I thought I got the revolver, but apparently I got the shotgun.
Oh, okay.
So,
Alright, so I have 5 melee.
So I'm gonna re-equip the shotgun then. So should have actually tried it before I upgraded it, but that's fine. Anyway, guys,
I have 5 weapons for the elf, so I should be able to. Yeah. They're not all exactly the same.
Actually, I might try the shotgun. It could be good. We'll try it out. Could be very good. So anyway, guys, I think we'll call this an episode here. Thanks for coming out for Warhammer Vermintide. We'll be back in the next episode for more. Thanks, guys. Later.